Hi friends, this is Vijay Kumar and I write code. So welcome back. It's been a while. I've come up with a video. It's because I was enjoying my vacations. They were really good. Okay, a big warm welcome, you know. So today this video will be introduction for the rest of the series. Well, we are starting a brand new series, that is a web development series for beginners. In this series we are gonna learn, discuss about making websites using PHP and MySQL, and it'll be fun. In this video I'm going to show you how to set up the environment, so let's begin. Well, let me tell you, the environment software depends upon the operating system you're using on, right? If you're using a Windows operating system, then you will have to download WAMP, W-A-M-P. Well, let me show it to you in written. I'm sorry for that. Notepad, all right. That is called WAMP, W-A-M-P. Hope that you can see that here. Yes, so it's WAMP. For what it stands is Windows and Apache, then MySQL and PHP, right? I'm sorry for the spelling. Right, and if you're using Linux, then use LAMP. All right, I guess you've got what the L stands for. It's Linux. All right, so go ahead, Google yourself and download your software. If you are using, if you're a Windows user, you can just download LAMP at SourceForge. You know, it's a very good website. You can get a whole bunch of open source softwares over there. So let's start. I have already downloaded my stuff over here. I usually store it in this folder for Windows. WAMP is somewhere over here. So this is the WAMP server. I'm using the 2.4 version. I don't know, you can check out the latest one and you can download one for yourself. So here we're gonna install it, and let me tell you, there must be Visual C++ installed in your system, otherwise it'll pop up with a bad error. Okay, so let's install this. Just click next, accept the agreement, next, and remember this in C WAMP. All right, over there you have it. Quick launch icon, next, and install. It might take a moment, a couple of minutes. Let me tell you, you must have all the required software installed, that is Visual C++. Well, mainly that is what is required. I don't think anything else is, might be required for this. So okay, let me tell you more about the series. In this series, you're gonna take a look on a basic PHP MySQL blog. Okay, so it'll be fun. We'll make a simple blog, authentication and all of that. It'll be awesome. It'll not be a full-edged thing, but it'll be cool one, and let me tell you, this thing is done well. I'm just searching for Mozilla Firefox. I guess I don't have it over here. Yes, here we go. I got it open. All right, finishing the installation and you're done. You must click allow access over here, so that it can, so that you can host your website. It's just a firewall thing. And yes, this one is to set up your SMTP server. SMTP is nothing but a simple mail transfer protocol, which is used to send email, in web servers. This, if you have a SMTP server installed in your system, then you can allot the necessary information over here. But if you don't, just leave it as it is, default, and hit next. Well, if you are hosting your website over over the web using a paid account or somewhere like triplewebhost.com, then you don't have to set up this whole thing, because they have it installed previously. And finish this. So you are installed now. You can find it over here, WAMP server. you can start it. And this small icon over here, yes, it turned green just now. That means the server is up and running, right? So here is it is Apache, PHP and MySQL all over package that we have got on our system running, and it's cool. So that's all is for the setup. From the next tutorial, we are going to start, you know, the basics of PHP and MySQL. In the rest of the tutorial, we'll be referencing an ebook that is, that is this thing, all right? PHP MySQL by Kelvin Young. It's a pretty good book, you know, the build your own database driven website using PHP and MySQL. I'll be referring this book so that I wouldn't be missing any concepts, you know. I won't be discussing the whole book, but a little of it, well, the important stuff, so that that will help you getting started. I know reading the whole lengthy book is so much boring, that's why you are referring to some videos. So I'll just help you out with that, and you can, so that you can understand yourself what all that other stuff means and get into the advanced stuff, right? So let's begin with the next video. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching and stay back, and I hope I didn't bore you. So bye bye, take care, I'll see you.